Hello friends, this is our 10th essay, that is of discourse. Discourse, you know, any verbal act is a discourse. Speaking is discourse, talking is discourse, writing is discourse. The discourse analysis we have, you know, isn't it? Discourse analysis. Now today we see, we have got the introduction and the three points, our main points we will see. The first point is that the honorable way of talking or speaking. How the honorable way, the honorable way of talking or speaking. This is more about speaking than writing. Discourse, according to Bacon's meaning, is speaking or talking, giving a speech and so on. So first point to note is that don't talk continuously on all things under the sun. There are some people like that. Do not talk continuously on all things under the sun. Some people, they start talking, they will never stop. They are called say mic addicts. Once they get the mic, they go on talking. They don't know where to begin, where to end. But continuously, that's very bad thing. Then use discretion. What is to be said? You should use your judgment, discretion, judgment. What is to be said? What not to be said? And again, if you suffer from poverty of topics, suppose you don't have many topics. Some people, they have only one topic. They know only about, say, one topic. So what do they do? Wherever they go, they will speak on that. Now, they say, suppose there is a speaker who knows only about democracy. Then he is invited to be the chief guest. He has to give the keynote address. He lectures on democracy. Now, it so happened that you happen to go somewhere else, and there also he comes. And there also he speaks on the same topic. That means he has only one. He has only one, and that is very boring. When people discover that, find that out, it will be boring as well as ridiculous. Understand? Then he says, talk on that subject which you know. And then speak to the point and be brief. This is the honorable way of speaking. So the honorable way of speaking is, within that you have got points like, first, don't talk too much, isn't it? Too much. Secondly, deals with poverty of topics. If you have poverty of topics, then that will be ridiculous. And third, it says that be brief and to the point. To the point. So these are the main points within this, the honorable way of talking or speaking. The second point is qualities of a good speech. Qualities of a good speech. When do you say that a speech is lively or good or standard? He says that it should have variation, first of all. The variation of tone. Sometimes the pitch should go up, sometimes it will come down, sometimes level. Like, let's take some ways that of Mark Antony's speech, the funeral oration of Mark Antony, isn't it? At the funeral of Julius Caesar. Friends, Romans, and countrymen, lend me your ears. See that going up and down. Listen. Then he can tell tales, stories. Within this, some variation, stories, tell stories. People always like listen to stories. However old or young you are, like listen to stories. Then ask questions, questions. Ask questions to the audience. Ask questions to the audience. Then what do you do? Say jokes, very important. Jokes. Humor, a sense of humor, isn't it? And ask opinion. Opinion of people. Or how do you think, like, or how do you feel? So this is the best way to keep the audience at your commands. See the variation of tone? See, listen to some of the great speeches. As the world sleeps, India awakes to freedom. That is twisted with this meaning. The Pandit Jawaharlal knows. As the world sleeps, India awakes to freedom. That is woman. Then, telling stories is very important. Relevant stories. Jokes is another important. These are important for classroom communication also. Asking opinion. The best class, I think, that a classroom communication involves all this. Various tone, not monotone. The other word is monotone, same tone. Yes. Then you have got, you can add your stories about your life or somebody's life, or stories that you have learned, studied, and so on. Jokes, sense of humor. A teacher should have a sense of humor and asking opinion of the students and so on. Now, third point is about jokes. Now, jokes, very careful, because don't hurt by joking. Is that possible? Don't joke about religion. Nobody will accept it. Don't joke about great persons, VIPs, or important business that a person is doing, or something that deserves pity. You find a beggar, don't crack a joke on him. But that deserves pity. For a sick man, you go to a hospital and see, this is the sick people and make fun, crack jokes in front of them, or about them. Say, what an incongruous thing is that. You should not do. Non-religion, don't touch religion, understand? And great persons, that's very dangerous. And then also, important business. So, jokes? No, don'ts. What are the don'ts? Religion, VIPs, then business of a person, an important person, and then pity. A sight that deserves pity. Anything that deserves pity. Anything that deserves pity. Listen, sir. Suppose that a lame person is moving like this, and don't look at him. That is actually, as the philosopher said, that is, you are not joking, you are not cracking, you are not fooling that person, but you have, that is, directly hits God, because he is God's creation. Don't do such kind of things. Then, fourth point is about questions. Questions should be honest. Honest means, you know, you should ask questions for learning, not troublesome questions. Or causing shame to the speaker. Understand? So, there are some people who they just want to put the speaker in trouble. So, don't ask troublesome questions. And also, personal questions. Don't ask. Yeah, how many times you got married? Things like that. So nonsense. Okay? Don't do it. So I'm saying. Listen. And allow others also to speak. There are some things that they happen. You know. Some people go on asking questions. Then all the others, they sit quiet. They are blinking. But you ask a question, one or two, and then allow others also to ask questions. And then there are some do's and don'ts. Do's and don'ts. At the end, do's and don'ts. So that is the fifth point. Do's and don'ts means, you know, first is, don't pretend ignorance. Some people, they are very scholarly, but they pretend ignorance. This said about Socrates, that he used to, when in his dialogues, he starts the dialogue pretending that he does not know anything about that topic. But actually that was a positive approach, because he wants to get what is your idea. Suppose he goes on explaining everything, then what will the other person do? So he pretends or he used to pretend that way. He does not know about a topic, then ask questions so that he can elicit answers from them. Please, don't pretend ignorance. Then don't talk about oneself. See, when I am talking, I say, oh, I have been in India, I have done my PhD, I have got many awards. Once I was, somebody asked me to take a, what is called, a chance in films, but I did not go. Yes, this kind of thing. About oneself. About others you can talk, but not a particular person. General. Then he says, use your judgment. Using judgment or discretion is far greater than to be eloquent. That's what it is. Conclusion is there. Your discretion, speaking with discretion, is far, far greater than speaking as a with the eloquence. So when you compare these two, which is most important, is your discretion. That's what it is. So what are the don'ts? First, don't is, first, what is the first don? Don't pretend ignorance. Don't. Pretend ignorance. Second is, talk about oneself. About oneself. Third is, talk about others, but not just one. And fourth is discretion. Discretion is judgment. Discretion is more than or greater than. Greater than. Can you hear? Eloquence. That's it. So these are the main points of discourse. In fact, whatever you want to know, the same, all these points are applicable in classroom communication also. Because there is a discourse. The teacher-student discourse. Yes. Students, beware. Don't go on asking questions to trouble your teacher. Teachers have some sense of humor. Jokes. You know, become very friendly with the students and so on. It's very important. Yes. So main points. One, the honorable way of talking or speaking is for that, don't talk too much. If you have poverty of topics, better don't go around and speak about that. It will be ridiculous and boring. Be brief and to the point. Second is qualities of a good speech, variation of tone, telling stories, asking questions, cracking jokes, and asking opinions. And three, jokes. Don't joke on religion, because that is very critical. You understand that? Yes. So religion, very important persons, very important business, anything that deserves pity. So when you find a mentally challenged person or a physically challenged person, don't make fun of it. Yes. Jokes, we are seeing. Questions, be honest. Don't ask trouble. Yes. Don't ask questions for troubling. Not troubling, no questions. Just for causing trouble. Trouble and also allow others. Allow others. This is a really golden rules. Yes. For speaking, discourse. If anybody is trying to give a class on public speaking, you can use all these points. All these points. The best speech is a speech which involves variations, stories, ask questions, jokes, and opinion. More than that, what you want. And now the last one is do's and don'ts. Don't pretend ignorance. Don't talk about oneself. Talk about others, but not just one person. And the do is discretion. Use your discretion. Sometimes just because you don't use your discretion, all your popularity and all of whatever you have and everything will simply vanishing the thin air. So judgment is greater than eloquence. You may speak eloquently, but if you are speaking wrong things, you are lost. Listen. I think that, so it's, as in the by way of introduction, this is enough. So tomorrow onwards we will get into this sentence by sentence, and at that end more explanations will be given. Till then, bye, have a nice day, enjoy yourself.